Whenever it comes to fashion, it seems that all black is the way to go if you want to play it safe. I mean, it's definitely a fundamental to the outfit creation process, but I don't think it's actually that good. Grayscale is where it's at, and this is the beauty of grayscale in fashion and how it can help you create better outfits. So first off, let's talk about the grayscale spectrum and how it's fundamental to creating your favorite colors. Anyways, the grayscale spectrum is the absence of color. Just take any photo and you drop the saturation slider and you have yourself the grayscale spectrum. Some white, dark and light gray, black of course, and yes, I did shoot this picture myself. Like I said earlier, your favorite colors are created through the grayscale spectrum. You take any color, you add white to it, it's gonna move it more towards pastel. And then if you add black to it, it's going to make it more dark. Think of forest green instead of primary green. And adding gray makes an in-betweener. Think olive or clay colors. I think dusty is probably a better term to explain it. You know, dusty purple, dusty blue. And so yes, the grayscale spectrum is technically monochrome. The proper term is actually achromatic, but I won't be addressing that today. But now you know the two terms. So here's what you're gonna do now. You're gonna pick any piece in the grayscale spectrum for your kicks, your pants, and your tops. Personally, I prefer white sneakers, black pants, and a dark gray wash top. That's always my go-to, but feel free to mix it up. This is the base that'll work for any outfit. And as you can see, this fit alone is already a vibe. Slap on any colored accessories or jackets of choice, and the grayscale canvas just allows the color to speak for itself. I personally think it's even better than an all-black canvas. Like, think of Rihanna's anti-album cover. Its base is rooted in the grayscale spectrum, but the two pops of red and gold are striking and make the album aesthetically pleasing. Sometimes mixing a bunch of colors doesn't bode well unless you really know what you're doing, and sometimes all black with a pop of color may not look as good either. Here are two fits I'm wearing, completely all black with a colored beanie versus a grayscale fit with the same exact beanie, and tell me which one you prefer. Exactly. All black isn't as solid as you think. Now, every black garment that you own will always be a different shade. Therefore, they will all technically be in the grayscale spectrum, just leaning more towards the black side. But what I'm encouraging y'all to do is to add a little bit of contrast. See, I hear all the time that you should wear all black because it'll elongate your body, make you look taller, yada, yada, yada. And no, it doesn't. That's a load of shit. Maybe for a solo fit pick, but the second you stand next to a taller person, you're just gonna look short. And I also hear that you should not wear white sneakers with black pants, and I'm astounded by that. Contrast is not a bad thing, and some of the coolest fits are created with black and white. And also, some of the most popular sneakers are created with contrast. Anyways, that was a little ramble right there. But let's just say you do want to start off with an all black clean slate. You know, black sneakers, black pants, black top. Yeah, sure, if you want, but I still think you would want a little bit of contrast. So skip out on the all black footwear and throw on a dark gray jacket, and you're still hitting that grayscale vibe while wearing a black top and black pants. And as you can see, there's endless possibilities. With the grayscale spectrum, gray next to black already adds some contrast. It shows intent. I mean, you're still playing it safe, but it's a little bit more tasteful than all black, IMHO. I mean, all black does have its time and place, I'm not denying it, but the grayscale spectrum, chef's kiss. Let's showcase some outfits, starting with a strictly grayscale outfit. No colored pieces, no colored accessories or jewelry, a truly desaturated outfit. This will showcase your understanding of proportions, and it's probably the easiest because most of y'all got sad boy wardrobes anyways, and you don't have to think about any color. You'll want to focus on different cuts and silhouettes. For example, you'll see me wear a white button up instead of a white t-shirt to provide texture and layering versatility. Anyways, we have a pair of wide fit black cargo pants from Fried Rice. These are those cargo pants that came with straps, but I've removed them and I cuffed them to showcase the high top chucks. I've always loved the look of that, and moving up, instead of a slate gray top, we are gonna roll with the Jill Sander button up with a mandarin collar. That's a lack of collar that stays flush against your neck. It's a unique piece. Looks nice without being too formal. And even the bag is completely all black. And the only gray pieces on the fits are the beanie that I got from Amazon, this titanium ring from a brand called Arxiom. It's a really dope piece, check out that brand. They even have Cloud's Buster Sword. And then this wool blend shirt from H&M's Premium Selection. This is a casual fit I think most people can rock. There's no crazy trendy pieces. This outfit is built off of staples. And yeah, like I said, this is a fit you can get creative with. There's no color, just focus on cuts and silhouettes. And aha! Take a look at this now. All you have to do now is throw on a colored bag, colored headwear, or frames, and wow, See how nice it looks? See, I totally get it if you don't like colored tops or colored pants. So if that's you, stick with your grayscale base and spend your money on colored accessories. Colored accessories are much cheaper than, let's just say, a colored shirt or colored pants if you look for the right piece. And you can wear it over and over again without question, therefore getting more bang for your buck. And so now I think you see where we're going. We're gonna start to incorporate a little bit more color. So up next is this classic colder weather outfit. I've done this two ways depending on what you're feeling for the day, depending on the weather also. But here are my staples and probably my most worn pieces during the colder months. The Randy Illusion cropped tech cargos. For those of y'all that are into tech wear, these are basically the Acronym P30s, just a lot more affordable. I wasn't too sure if I would like the drop crotch look, but now that I got this piece, I'm definitely gonna pick up the Acronym P30s eventually, and I'll pass these pants along to family. Not to deny that this piece is still pretty solid for the price. You get a built-in adjustable belt, that drop crotch look, removable cuffs for the cropped look, and of course a DWR coating making these water repellent. I love the aggressive tapering on this. It starts off really wide and tapers nicely. The other staples are this slate gray oversized talentless hoodie and the Jill Sander Uniqlo padded coat, which is also water repellent and super warm, so this would technically count as a tech fit. Those are the staples, and footwear wise, it's either a pair of Doc Martens or the Oliver Cabell white leather sneaker. Both pair really well with this fit and stays in that grayscale look. And then I'll slap on any colored accessory, either a colored beanie with the white sneakers or keep the beanie black, but throw on a bright yellow sling bag for a statement. This one specifically is from A Cold Wall and I think it's pretty nice. Definitely a little bit pricey though. So we're gonna stay in that grayscale spectrum for the main pieces and accent it with colored accessories. And it's funny, this outfit was actually inspired by this keyboard right here. It just shows that you can get inspired by anything. This keyboard rolls with black, dark gray, light gray, and has just a little tiny pop of color. I don't have an orange bag, so I just threw on a yellow bag, but you get where I'm going. So yeah, this is a good date outfit or for going out. Y'all saw me on Instagram at this art exhibit. It was pretty dope. And the coat, I'm telling you, I'm gonna make a whole entire video about coats, but a coat just makes it so easy to come up with a good fit. And finally, we have a more simplistic fit, but we're really gonna embrace color in this one, just with that grayscale base. So this time our base consists of the same Oliver Cabell white leather sneakers and the same talentless hoodie, but this time we are going to add some patchwork trousers from the brand Rosen. Y'all know I really love this brand. This one is from the standard Rosen, which focuses on simplicity and avant-garde cuts. What I love about this comes from their Bazaar collection, which upcycles leftover fabrics into a unique piece. And I believe this was a one-of-a-kind piece, but you can get the same piece yourself. It's called the Play-Doh trousers, just all black. This one has your classic soft trouser feel mixed with this patch of gray, and it looks pretty sick. And so now we can add some colored pieces, and this time we'll be using a little more color blocking techniques. The jacket is one of my favorite denim jackets I own. This is the collaboration between Levi's and White Mountaineering from 2020. You see a mix of different shades of blue and olive, which if you guys didn't know, olive is actually green with gray added to it, making the jacket alone fall under the analogous colors or colors right next to each other on the color wheel. It's why the Windows XP wallpaper is so iconic, that blue and green. Anyways, because the jacket is mainly blue, opposite of blue on the color wheel is orange. So I threw on this orange beanie that I got from Amazon, and now we are following complementary color blocking. Then we got some other accessories as well, some jewelry and all that. And like I said many, many times in this video, the grayscale base allows for these colors to pop. And that's just the beauty of grayscale. Colors just look so good. Now here's what it would look like with an all black base, you know, black hoodie, black pants. I mean, it still looks decent. However, I'm definitely picking the grayscale base every time because almost nobody truly wears all black. There's always some accents of color or some contrast. You have to think about layers, texture, and even then, sometimes it doesn't look right. If you look at almost any product, there's always some sort of contrast of white, pop of color. Like, just take a look at this lens. If this lens was entirely all black, it just wouldn't look as good. And they even presented it with a gray lens cap. For your average person, I think it's easier to roll with grayscale versus learning about layering, textures, proportions, and all that. That takes time and experience. So there you have it. You've got a lot of options, and this allows you to focus on the basics first. If you can nail the grayscale spectrum, you are on your way to creating some sick fits. If you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and follow me on the other socials, my other channels. And until then, stay fly, deuces.